What's he got in the tank tonight?
And they are away.
7 world championships.
Michael Klim with all of the medals.
5 Commonwealth golds.
Australia gold.
2 Olympic golds.
New world record.
21 world records. He smashed them in the pool.
Well done, Michael Klim. Well done, Klimmy boy.
To the best of your ability, just shift your weight to the right. Okay.
And this is Michael Klim in 2019, struggling to walk on the legs that propelled him to victory. The memory of his helplessness at Kuala Lumpur Airport still fresh.
I literally had to sit down on the floor. There was no seats through the airport, and I called Michelle and I was literally in tears because I couldn't pinpoint what it was. That was probably one of the scariest moments I had. For me, my ability to do anything physical was something that I used to pride myself on and used to give me mental strength. And bit by bit was being taken away.
It was nearly a year before the doctors finally identified an autoimmune disorder.
It's chronic inflammatory demyelinating polyneuropathy. So
and what is that?
Basically means where the sheath of the nerves are sort of, they're fray and they're actually, your body is actually eating, it's trying to protect itself, but it's eating your own tissue. So in my case, it's eating the outside of my nerves.
So what has happened to your legs?
Basically, I've lost sensation in both of my feet. I've got a little bit of function in my left foot, minimal in my right foot, and pretty much lost all calf muscles on both sides. Lost most of my quad on this one.
Michael lives in Bali with his partner Michelle. They share custody of his 3 children with his ex-wife. But Michael has to leave his family behind for weeks on end for special treatment at Sydney's RPA hospital.
Back in Sydney, my favourite spot. Back for the infusions. It's an immunoglobulin replacement therapy. It comes from blood donors, which is incredible. There's about 10 donors for every bottle that I can, get infused, which I go through about 6. So about 60 people help me through every treatment that I have.
Back in Bali, between treatments, he started a course of steroids to see him through the next few months. But they came with unwanted side effects.
Started giving me glaucoma and started getting a moon face. Also put on weight and mentally you go up and down on a daily basis.
Just see if you can minimise the amount of sway you have.
And you've just got no push through that right foot, hey?
I started going downhill really quickly. So I think from January through to May, I literally lost the ability to get around the house.
By June last year, something had to give.
There was just that one significant moment where Michael kept falling over and unable to hold himself up, and it was happening in front of the kids too, and I think that's when they really saw there's something going on with Dad, and it was quite scary for them to see that and for all of us. And we had to make that hard decision. It's like, we've got to go now.
Doctors in Sydney noticed Michael's old injuries to his ankle and back were exacerbating his condition. He needed a back operation to relieve the compressed nerves.
I couldn't walk, so I had 2 nurses trying to help me to even get to the bathroom or anywhere. So it took me a while until I could walk down the corridor in the hospital, and then I had to check myself into another hospital for the rehab period because it's too much. I'm too heavy for her to carry me everywhere, so...
Throughout the battle, Michael's former swimming mates were by his side, protecting him from the glare of unwanted publicity. This was the 20th anniversary of their victory at the Sydney Olympics.
Righto, Mike, you ready to fight?
Born ready.
Probably be carrying Thorpe as usual.
The guys knew, so they would always... Chris, for example, were walking out for an appearance and he said, I'd walk in just in front of you a little bit if you need to grab my belt or something. And, my friends actually astounded me.
Kowalski's out of the water. Look at that. Come on, Australia.
And then there was Daniel Kowalski.
He literally gave me the keys to his house. And when we were back for treatment, then he said, stay here as long as you need.
And Thorpe as well?
Yeah, Thorpe is just an incredible human being. You know, he was calling the Mayo Clinics, all the doing the research for me and being proactive. active and in terms of making sure that I'm doing all the right things.
He has been there. He has been even calling me going, is he okay? How are you? He's asked me how I am, and he gave me the nickname of the human walking stick because that's what I am to Michael.
Throughout it all, Michael remained optimistic.
Now I always thought, I'll end up getting that full recovery, but I haven't exactly had a recovery. I sort of maybe I got worse and then I sort of maybe got a little bit better, but I've just plateaued out.
Although there's no end in sight, the support from his parents has also been unwavering. Eva and Wojtek came to Australia from Poland in 1989 with two suitcases and two kids.
You know, I did the maths on how much driving that you and Eva must have done in taking him to swim training and competitions. I worked out it's roughly a couple of times around the planet.
Probably, but the petrol was much cheaper at the time.
So when you put that much time and effort and love and belief into your son, and then you get that moment of seeing your boy standing up there on the podium with a gold medal around his neck, can you describe what that moment is like for you?
You break my heart, I'm sorry, but it was a great moment, you know. Sorry.
You love your boy?
Very much.
So, with all of that love, it must make what Michael's going through at the moment so much harder.
You know, it makes us only stronger as a family. I must say, I hope that he'll get through this, but it is tough.
And particularly tough on Michael's three children.
You can just hold me up when I'm walking.
So have we got any potential Olympic swimmers here?
Maybe not. I'm not too sure about us.
I have best, second best, third best.
And Dad has obviously had to come back to Australia a lot to have treatment.
Yeah, it was hard because we didn't get to see him for a while. But then when he would come back, it would be a lot of fun.
Missed you.
Can you imagine going through all of this without Michelle now?
No way. No, she's been, I don't want to use a cliche, but obviously a rock to me because, I might end up in a wheelchair one day. But, her answer was like, I'm here for the long run, no matter what the outcome is.
So has your mental strength been something that you've had to rely on?
It's interesting you say that because the people that I've told, I've spoken to about my CIDP, they've said, you're an Olympic athlete. You've got that mental strength to get you through this. And it's actually hasn't necessarily been the case. It's not like I can do extra exercises or this or that to, if anything, sometimes I've been more despondent about it and it's more depressing. And, I've gone through phases where even when I drank too much and tried to numb the pain.
So how do you see you now?
Look, I think, look, initially I was thinking, why was I dealt this card? I was feeling sorry for myself and I almost felt like this was punishment for something. I give myself about an hour a day to feel sorry and angry and frustrated and whatever other emotion comes into my mind, and then move on with the rest of life.
And that means he's gone back to work, restarting his swim school in Bali. His love affair with the water far from over.
Great leg, love the ankle.
I'm swimming probably every second day. Obviously, when I'm not standing up and I can just float, it used to be my happy place. It's even more happy now.
So so incredible for him to share this story. And the thing with athletes like that, we think they're superhuman and we freeze them in time when we watch them at things like the Olympics and we think that is them forever. Mm. And stories like this just make you realise they're all human and these kind of things happen, and it must be so difficult to be dealing with that after having those heights of athletic prowess, you know. Must be just so tough, tough for him, and amazing for him to share the story.
Worth pointing out also that we've actually already heard from a lot of fellow sufferers of this debilitating condition. I've got to say, it's not one I knew about previously. Either. So many of you getting in touch with us, explaining how hard it's been actually to get support via the NDIS for it. So we're putting a bunch of information up on the website now about CIDP if you want to read more or find out more about it. And I think probably we all would say this to Michael, you know, thinking of you at the moment. Thank you for telling us all. I think the whole nation will want to be with you on this journey, as you put it, wherever it goes. So
absolutely.
Thinking of you at the moment.